guys. Bear with me, I'm just doing this from my laptop. I've never done one of these, so today I'm going to show you a look I created last night when I bought a new palette. I can't afford the big name palettes like Jeffree Star. As much as I would love a Jeffree Star palette, I have other priorities. I have a special needs child. So I bought this at Five and Below last night. I was killing time waiting for my husband to get off work, and I had to go up to Lawrence anyways because that's where I do all my grocery shopping. I did notice last night that it can have quite a bit of fallout, but they don't have eyeshadow names or anything, so I'll just point to the ones I'm going to be using. This is the Neon Brights palette from Color Co. This is only $5. I needed more eyeshadows because I really don't have very many. I usually use this one. This one was gotten for me for Christmas. I've used all of the brown. Oh, there's still a little bit in there. I don't know if you can see it or not. It's like right up in the corner. I've used quite a bit of the silver and the gold. The gold's almost gone too. Or I use this one. I lost the lid for it, but I think it's Secret Lace. Pretty sure that's what it was called. Let me see if I have the... Oh, hey, it's right here. I found it. Yeah, it's just Secret Lace. It was bought for me a couple of years back, but I don't wear makeup very often, so... But we're gonna stick with the Neon Brights. I don't know where my phone is. So I can't... Oh, wait. Yes, I do. Hold on. Oh, stop it. I don't want my spell book. Sorry. It's in... My gallery's in the same place as my D&D spell book. This is what we will be trying to recreate. I did it I just wanted to see the colors, see how they looked. So I did a look for my favorite NFL team, which is the Packers. Which is weird considering I live near Kansas City. You'd think I'd be a Chiefs fan, but I'm not. But first, I'm going to start with the face. Now I use mostly dollar store, or well, not dollar store, but drugstore makeup. I think the most expensive thing I have will be this. It's my Mary Kay CC cream. I mix it with my Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation. I'm in soft beige. I have a lot of red in my face, so this, it's a color correcting cream, CC cream, so it helps give me more of an even tone, and then I use this as my primer. I don't know if you can see it or not. It's Skin Lights from Revlon. This is the Bare Light one. And if I get really close to anything, it's because I can't see without my glasses. So, all right, let me take my ring off. Oh. Now my mirror is right here, just off camera, so. Alright. Now, I waited till I started recording to show you guys this. This is how small it is. Okay, this is my concealer. Here's how small it is before it's wet. Now, or damp, whatever. Now this is the Equate Beauty Classic Blender Sponge. It has vitamin E in it, and it's latex free, which is good because I'm actually allergic to latex. So, hang on, I'm wringing it out. There we go. Now here it is. It grew quite a bit. Now it's soft. I used it last night without it being wet, and I made that mistake, so you guys don't have to. It was actually pretty hard. Now, I used to use this. It's the Maybelline Fit Me in Classic Ivory. But I've had it for like 3 years, and I didn't realize you're supposed to change. Hold on. Since I don't use makeup that often, I didn't know that you weren't supposed to use it after a certain time. But this one, they said it's supposed to have. Let's see if this one has it. This one doesn't have it either. Well, hold on, let me see about this one. Jesus. I don't think any of my makeup has that on there. Okay. Well, most makeups have, like, this little jar thing on them that tells you how long they're, I guess you could say, how long they're good for after they've been opened. I can't get this damn thing to peel. Yeah, see, this one doesn't either. Huh. I don't know. But on most makeups, like this. This one's good for 18 months. But I just bought this like a month ago. So, and this is the Hard Candy 24K highlighter. This is my favorite highlight. I use it very often. But, a lot of my stuff you'll be able to get Walmart or Dollar Tree. I do have something from Dollar Tree. Just bear with me. Actually, no, I take that back. This Mary Kay is not my most expensive one. This is. This was given to me, though. So I didn't spend any money on it. This is my bronzer that I use for my contour. And then my, I don't know who my concealer is. I think it's CoverGirl. I know I've got a, yeah. Because here's a CoverGirl lipstick. Looks almost identical. But I'm not using that one in this tutorial. I'm either going to be using my Revlon or my LA Colors red lipstick, which is my life. But another lipstick I do use that I love, it was given to me. Let me see. I played with it last night. I know one is in here somewhere. But it's a Burt's Bees lipstick. So, alright. So, I'm going to do is, I do this different from everybody. I put my foundation on my face instead of on the back of my hand or on my sponge, just because it's what works for me better. So let's see if I can. Whoop! I need to scoot the laptop over. Ooh, tilt it back for a minute. Okay, you guys are gonna see my mirror, okay, in the screen. Okay, let me. Do I have another hair tie in here? No, I don't. Okay, bring some more light in here. I love using the natural light on my window because it helps me see what's still wet when I put on my press pop. All right, so this first. So now that that's done, we're going to take Wet n Wild's Photo Focus foundation, and it's got this little thin, I like it better than my old Maybelline, which I do love the Maybelline. Because I didn't break out as much, but I didn't like that. So, I thought about switching tops, but I don't think that it'll fit. Oh, it might. But, let's shake. I don't know if anybody else shakes their foundation up, but I do, just because I prefer to. Now, I've had this foundation for for as long as I've had my highlighter. I bought them literally at the same time. Now, most people, or most women, some women, I don't know if all women do, but every woman I've seen do tutorials uses fake eyelashes, but I wear glasses. And my lenses are really thick, so I can't exactly wear fake eyelashes. Here, to give you an idea of how thick my glasses are, I have really bad eyes. My left cornea is almost completely flat, so seeing out of my left eye is a lot harder for me, and I'm extremely nearsighted. So I can't wear false lashes. I've tried. All right. Now, I don't do my brows. I just prefer not to. Now, I have a very wide nose. So these crevices are really deep. So I usually take like a tiny little brush or something like that to kind of get in there better. But now my brushes are cheap brushes. So, I ordered mine off Wish, and I like them. Now, a couple of them I've had for a while, but I clean and I disinfect them regularly, so they're not as gross as people would think. Like this one, I don't even know where I got this one. And then I have this one. I don't know the brand, but it's really soft and I love it. And I do need to clean these. Okay, so let's go ahead and, ooh, I need to buy another one of these. Good thing I gotta go to Dollar Tree soon anyways. Yeah, this is Beauty Benefits Hollywood. I got it at Dollar Tree and I use it a lot. I think I actually saw Jeffree Star, I want to say. Pretty sure it was him. Use this in his Dollar Tree makeup try on or whatever those are called. I love Jeffree Star. He's probably the only tutorial makeup person that I watch religiously besides Christine. I mean, I literally bought my daughter a pair of holographic shoes. So even though they were 50, or actually they were like 16 something after tax. Do need to get another one of these. So, all right. There's an eyelash stuck to my nose. All right. Now, I do contouring after I do my eyeshadow, so this is not the use for my eyes. I'm going to go in. I don't have a fluffy brush per se. I have this, but it's hard and it hurts my eyes. So I go in with these two. Now you can see that the green kind of stained my brush a little bit. That's okay. Cause it'll be gone after I clean it. And then this is what I use for under my eye. It's just a tinier version of this. So we're going to go in first with this dark green. And we're going to, oh, hold on. I did almost forget. Oh shit. Hey! Look at that! It's still in one piece! Oh, I'm so glad about that. Oh, I didn't want to have to go to Lawrence to buy a new palette. Okay. Like I said, I'm blind, so bear with me. Well, I'm blind without my glasses. I'm not actually blind. All right, I know you're here. Where are you? There you are. So I go in. I know most people use an actual eye primer, but I've tried a actual eye primer with this palette last night, and it didn't really come out that well. So I tried my concealer, and it seems to have worked better than my eye primer. I gotta see what time it is. Either or 1:30. Okay. I have to be there at pick up my husband from work. All right, now. Now we're gonna go in with this darker green. That's the small one. I need the big one. Well, what the? There it is. It's down here. And go in with this dark green right here. Tap it off once, and then right into the crease. Now, I know some of you probably just looked at the screen and was like, what the fuck did she just do? I found it's the best way to get my crease because I do have odd shaped eyes. I have astigmatisms. So I found that going according to how my eye is shaped, it makes my eyelids look better. Now, this color is, or this look isn't exactly the greatest for my eyes because I do have green eyes. But when I go in with the darker yellow, it'll bring out the yellow that's in my eyes and make it just a little bit better. So, then we're gonna go in with this light green. And we're going to tap it off and then go right over. Sorry, my phone just vibrated. A little bit of that darker green, try to bring it out or tone it down a little bit. And then right here on the eye. Now, before I go in with the yellow, I like to take, somebody joined my Discord. I'm a Twitch streamer, so my Discord, I'm part of a Discord. It's not my actual Discord, but you guys get the point. So we're gonna clean this up a little bit. Then bring it over. And then do the same on this side. Clean it up. All right. All right, and now we're going to go in. This one I just put down there. With, hang on. This yellow right next to the light green we just used. Tap it off. And then just tap it right on to where we just put that concealer. Now this palette, the reason I put the concealer down is it looks like it has a lot of pigment in the pan, but once, here, let me just show you. Here, let me get a clean brush. I can't find my bag of brushes. I try to avoid putting my glasses on until I do my setting spray. So let's show you with this thing. Anybody else remember these damn things? Alright, so I'll go with this blue. Now, I messed with this blue yesterday, and it was actually pretty, but can you see how there's not a whole lot of pigment there? Now let's see. There's just not a whole lot of pigment. So I'll have to clean that up later, but I found that the concealer helps kind of bring out or put more of that color on. So we're just gonna go ahead and put just a little bit more on there. Perfect. Now I am in my PJs, even though it's 1 o'clock in the afternoon. But it's also Friday, so I don't do shit on Fridays. Now I'm going to go in with this brush and soften it up a little bit. Kind of blend them all in. There. Better. Now I'm going to step into this one and take my little brush, my mini version of that brush. I'm going to take this silver right here and highlight my brow bone. Just because I love this color. I try not to use it a whole lot because they don't sell this palette anymore. They bought it. I got it for Christmas, and it was one of those Christmas special palettes that Walmart had out. So, alright, now you guys are probably going to yell at me when you see the brush that I use for contour and highlight, but don't. Oh man. My fluffy brush fell into the sink. Alright, so I use what I think is a foundation brush. Ow! I just knocked off that fucking Maybelline foundation onto my foot. And this bottle is glass. That's going to be a nice little fucking bruise tomorrow. Alright, so I'm going to go in with my Hoola Benefit Bronzer. This is color... It doesn't say what color it is. Tells you where to put it, though. Six Y O 1. It's kind of red. See, well, it's decently close-ish to my summer color. So there's that one. Now I have curves. I don't have a straight. No, I also do this because I have a fat face. So I do it kind of heavy to help thin out my face. Except for up here. I try not to do it super heavy, just because I do have a smaller forehead. All right. Now, I take my fluffy brush and get most of it. Discord again, I think. Yep, both Discords I'm in. My husband is also a streamer. So, speaking of husband, I'm gonna call his work. Hey, you're off at 2, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I just wanted to double check.
What?
I just wanted to double check. Okay. I'll be there here in a little bit. All right. I love you. Bye. All right. So, I make some weird faces, don't judge. Ooh. Alright, for that, I need this. Now, I would love, sorry, to have a different type of concealer. I would love to have, or concealer. Sorry, I have chocolate all over my lid for my daughter. Ooh. Now, I am part of the Metal Straw Club, fan club, or whatever you want to call it. Me and my husband, because of where my husband works, we go through a lot of plastic straws. And to be honest, I hate it. Alright, so need my highlight, which I need that brush back. Let's clean it off. Now, I'm going to use the gold. I try not to use too much because it can leave a yellow tint to my skin. Just gonna highlight right there by the contour. Whoop! Oh, and I just realized I didn't bring the shadow down. I'm gonna come down the nose. Now, I actually love my nose, so I don't contour it. I think I have a pretty good nose, so I don't mess with it. My bathroom's kinda hot. Alright, so I'm not going to bring that darker green down. I'm just going to bring the light green. Yeah, and I'm going in with that tiny brush. Tap off. And I'm going to bring the green about halfway to right about where the yellow gets more prominent. Sorry, I sing a lot. Alright, and then I'm going to bring this yellow down as well. And this side. All right. Now, I'm not sure where this eyeliner came from. It just appeared in my makeup drawer one day. So we're going to use. Excuse me. We're going to use this one. Alright, so I'll be back in a second. Because I have to have the mirror closed for eyeliner. Those look even. Sorry, guys. All right, and then I'm going to go in with LA Colors Volumizing Mascara. I got this at Dollar Tree. Ever done makeup knows exactly what I just did. I stabbed myself in the eye with my mascara. Next time. Now, I do two mascaras. I'm just gonna find the other one. I gotta put it back in the box. I did. I'm going to go in with CoverGirl's Lash Blast Volume Mascara. It's got a brush that looks like this, and I fucking love it. Just gives a little more length to my eyelashes. I bought it after I accidentally burned off part of my eyelashes. I noticed it also kind of helped them
come back, grow back a little faster. You don't want to hear the embarrassing story about how I burnt off part of my eyelash. Because it also resulted in burning off part of my eyebrow. But it wasn't too bad on my eyebrow. Alright. So there we go. Eyelashes and eyeliner are done. Now, I think I'm going to do my red lipstick. I do have a Sephora lipstick, but that one's not exactly affordable. That one was like $18 or something like that. So, alright. Just gonna... go in with my red lipstick. This looks a little more pink lately. I also haven't been using... You are in a dangerous place. Let's try to... redden this up. There we go. Now, every April, part of the reason that I got into red lipstick is because every April I participate in this thing called Red My Lips Month, or Red My Lips. It is for sexual assault awareness. And a few years back, when I first found out about it, it was like 2013, something like that. I bought my first red lipstick to support that. Sorry, my lips just look uneven. There, that's better. I bought my first red lipstick for that. Because I had just found out about it, but I am a sexual assault survivor. So I wear red lipstick a lot to remind people that it's not the makeup that's on my face, it's not the clothes that I wear that targeted me. It was the guy that targeted me. So, alright, so this is my favorite setting spray. This is the Hard Candy. Hang on. There's a hair. Brightening Sheer Envy setting spray. I actually got this on sale. It was like $3 or something like that. It has rose water in it and vitamin C. All right. So, there we go. Whew. Okay, I'm gonna... there we go. All right. And that is how you do Green Bay Packers inspired eye makeup. I just really love red lipstick. I could have gone with my satin plum, which that's actually really pretty. I love it. It's like a nudie purple. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. I absolutely love it. But that's more for date night. On the rare occasion that me and my husband actually can afford to go out. So, I will come up with a new look. And next week, hopefully, I will have a new video for you guys. See you next time.